When you boil it down, research is about answering a question you're curious about. That question could be something people in your field of study need to know about, or just something you want to know more about. We typically envision research as a linear process. You pick a topic, then you find some journal articles and books, and then once you've read them, you're ready to start writing your paper. But research often actually looks and feels more like this. It's messy, creative, and it requires mental flexibility. And that's what makes it so rewarding. In order to develop a solid research question, you must first choose a topic to explore. That first step, choosing a topic, isn't always easy. It can take time and is actually part of the research process itself. And remember, when you first pick a topic, it isn't set in stone. It's just a starting point for further research. Doing some initial searches in a library catalog or on the web might just open up more questions or send you in a different direction, and that's okay. Even once you start writing, you might realize that you need to find additional sources and go back to the research stage. This is called an iterative research process. Let's try an example. Perhaps you've recently learned about the legacy of redlining, a historic discriminatory housing practice used across the United States, but you're not sure where to go from there. You might start with a general internet search on redlining or the history of redlining, which might bring up Wikipedia articles, newspaper articles, and more. This is still a really broad topic, but some initial searches might bring up additional questions like, what are the long-term health effects of redlining? Now this is a research question you can seek to answer. However, once you start digging into the library databases, like Academic Search Ultimate, to find the peer-reviewed academic sources you need, you realize you're still getting way too many sources. So you tweak your topic to be a bit more specific. You might narrow it by a specific medical condition, like asthma, and maybe even an age group, like children, or by a geographic location, like Baltimore. Now you've got two solid options for a research question you can explore in your paper. What is the relationship between asthma and children and the legacy of redlining? Or what are the long-term health effects of redlining in Baltimore City? You might be tempted to get even more specific and limit your results to an individual neighborhood like Sandtown, Winchester. But then you don't get quite enough results to make an argument. It's important to look for that sweet spot, not too broad, but not too narrow. By following this process of using research to refine a topic and turn it into a question, you can avoid realizing too late that your topic is unresearchable or drowning in a sea of research from a topic that is too broad in scope. Remember to build in the time to explore your topic so you can take an idea and shape it into a research question that you still find interesting and can realistically use for a research assignment. For more help developing a research question, please contact us at the Sheridan Libraries. We're here to help.